And I want to show you what it takes to open this book to our understanding, and you could see why God would be offended by that. And we all should be. We all should be. It really gets right to the heart of why men don't understand and why this whole world is deceived. Now, the Father revealed this book, and He says you should become perfect as the Father in heaven is perfect, Matthew 5 and verse 48. But Christ repeatedly made statements like, "My Father is greater than I." So this came from the Father. It didn't come from Christ or an angel or a man. It came from the Father, the supreme being in the universe. And it says in Matthew 24, verses 29 and 36, that no man or angel knows the day or the hour when Christ is going to return. Not even Christ Himself knows. The Father knows. So, does Christianity exalt the Father or the Son, Christ? Need to answer that question because it's a very important one, really. But look at all the confusion there is in this world about the book of Revelation. And 1 Corinthians 14 and verse 33 says, God is not the author of confusion, but who is? Well, the one that is talked about a great deal in this book of Revelation, and I'll cover some of it today. But the book of Revelation gives us a time frame or time sequence for all prophecy. And so if you don't understand this book, you don't understand any prophecy, really, then that's one-third of your Bible. One-third of your Bible is prophecy. 90% of it is for today. That's why it's so critical that we understand this message today. We can't be careless and ignorant if we're going to understand what is happening in this world. What does God tell us what's going on in Europe? Yes, He does. North America, South America, yes, He does. Asia, oh yes. Middle East, you bet He does. It's all prophesied here in this book. It's all made much clearer than you've ever dreamed right here in this book. But there's something we have to do if we're going to understand it, and an understanding that we must have. But I want to show you first what comes from that understanding. Notice verse 3. Blessed is he that reads, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand. Yes, it is. The time is at hand, and we're blessed. You see, blessed is he that reads, that is, he reads and studies, and God reveals it to him, because he is submissive and childlike and wants God to teach him. And then they that hear the words of this prophecy, are they, you see, hear what he says as he proclaims this word. And they hear it and they love it and they're blessed mightily because they respond to it. All of them. It's an amazing thing, but God does work through a man to reveal it. He reveals it to a man as he did to John. And then John proclaims it, and then throughout history, God has a man proclaim it. And then people that see that this is really the living Word of God, well, they get excited about it, and they want to follow God as He leads a man. That's the way it has always worked. That's why God says, he that reads. He that reads is going, then he gets that revelation and that understanding, and that is critical to understand. You see, then the people follow the man that Christ is revealing it to, giving revelation to. And they know by that they're following Christ. They're not following a man. Cursed be the man that follows man, it says in Jeremiah 17 and verse 5. Now you see, again, one-third of the Bible is opened up by this book of Revelation. And almost all of it is for this end time today, the time that we're living in. So let me give you the giant key to understanding this book of Revelation. I mean, it is critical that you and I understand this. Revelation 5, verses 1 through 6. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the backside, sealed with seven seals. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the book and to loose the seals thereof?" And no man in heaven nor in earth, neither under the earth, was able to open the book, neither to look therein. And I wept much because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. So here is John, who actually cried because he couldn't see anybody that was there to open the book. I mean, this is serious. This is about life, eternal life, and eternal death. It's serious, and John realized that. But there was a solution. Verse 5, "And one of the elders said unto him, Weep not, behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has prevailed to open the book, and to loose the seven seals thereof. And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne, and of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb, as it had been slain." Oh, here, now we're getting down to the real fundamental message. Christ the Lamb was sacrificed for us, shed His blood for us. He didn't sin at all, but He shed His blood for us. He died for us so that He could cover our sins, and so that if we then came to Him in a submissive, childlike attitude, He would reveal His truth to us. He would reveal this book of Revelation to us. He is the sacrificial lamb, and He wants us to be willing to follow that sacrificial lamb, the Lion of Judah. We, too, have to sacrifice if we're going to follow the sacrificial lamb. We have to do some sacrificing ourselves. That's what people don't want to do. They want an easy, comfortable life, and they don't want to get out of their comfort zone. But God is going to insist that we do that if we follow Him. It says in Matthew 11 and verse 25, He's revealed these things unto babes, or people with a childlike attitude. You can see that in Matthew 18 verses 1 through 3. And then Matthew 24 verses 3 and 4 talks about many will come in my name, the name of Christ, and shall be deceived. I mean, it's about, there's just all kinds of deception going on. I'll just give you one definition that a scholar gave, not a pretty good one, I think, to a degree, to a point, but he said, how do you understand the book of Revelation? And he said, well, first, you need a knowledge of the Greek and the Hebrew. Well, that's good to have, but that's not, doesn't get to the point here. And he says, number two, a taste for poetry and painting, and you need to have a knowledge of history. And then if you have all those, you can understand the book of Revelation. But that's not true. That's not biblical. That's not what the Bible says. I mean, a lot of men have those qualities, and they don't understand this book and couldn't understand it in a trillion years. See, many authorities make statements like that, but Christ said, and the Father said, that it is the Lamb who is qualified to open this book. He shed His blood, and He is qualified for the Father to give it to Him and reveal it to all of us. That sacrificial Lamb, He's worthy. And so that's the way the Father does it. And there's the blood of the Lamb, the blood of the Son of God we're talking about here. So this is serious business, very serious. You can go on and read Revelation chapter 6 and see there that it talks about the seven seals, which is what this book is all about, the book of Revelation. And you can see in Revelation 6 that the meaning of those words are not there, so you have to look elsewhere. Let me read to you what Herbert W. Armstrong wrote years ago. He wrote this, "And God used symbols to hide the meaning from men until that meaning is revealed by none other than Jesus Christ Himself. He has here merely opened up the words in symbolic form, but not here the meaning of those words." And then he writes, "And since Jesus Christ, the Revelator, does not reveal the meaning in this particular passage of Scripture, we must look elsewhere." Now keep in mind,